Morning students, today question number, we start with the question number 105. A person buys one lottery ticket from each of the 50 lotteries in a town. In each of these, he has chance to win a prize is 1 by 100. What is the probability that he will get? Now here, total number of tickets are 50. So, n is equal to 50. Probability of winning prize is 1 by 100. So your Q will be 1 minus 1 by 100, that is 99 by 100. Okay. He take one ticket. A person buys one lottery ticket from each of the lotteries in a town. He will get at least one prize, exactly one prize, at least two prize. So first question is, here first we make a formula for probability distribution. So P of x is equals to x is ncx e raised to x u raised to n minus x. So that is equal to 50cx, p is 1 upon 100 raised to x, q is 99 upon 100 raised to 50 minus x. Okay, so that is equal to, we can write 50cx, here it is 99 raised to 50 minus x upon 100 raised to 50. That is the probability distribution for this problem. Now first question is, at least one prize. At least one prize. Okay, at least one prize means you have to find P of x greater than or equal to 1. P of x greater than or equal to 1 means we have to find 1 minus P of x is equals to 0. Because x greater than or equal to 1 means x equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 50. So, a find karani pehla apne shun karshu ke total probability is 1. x equal to 0, any price no, but any probability I will subtract from the 1. So that is equals to 1 minus. If you substitute 0 here at the place of x, then it is 50cx, 50c0 into 99 raised to 50 minus 0 is 50 upon 100 raised to 50. So that is equals to 1 minus 99 upon 100 raised to 50. Okay, second question. Exactly one price. Exactly one price. Means you have to find P of x equal to 1. Okay. So P of x equal to 1, that is 50C1 into 99 raised to 50 minus 1 is 49 upon 100 raised to 50. So 50C1 is 50. Here I can write 99 raised to 49 upon 100 raised to 49 into 100, 100 raised to 15 split here, 100 raised to 49 into 100. So 50 by 100 is 1 by 2, and that is 99 by 100 raised to 49. Third question, at least two price. So at least two price means you have to find P of x greater than or equal to 2. So P of x greater than or equal to 2 means we have to find 1 minus P of x is equals to 0 plus P of x is equal to 1. Okay. So that is 1 minus. We have already found 1 here. P of x equal to 0. That is 99 raised to 100 upon 50. That is x equal to 0. And P of x equal to 1. Here we have to, we have already found, that is 1 by 2 raised to 99 upon 100 raised to 49. Okay, so if I simplify this, I can write 99 upon 100 raised to 49 common. So into the bracket, here it will be 99 by 100 and here it is 1. So 1 minus LCM is 100. F50 multiply karo, so 90 plus 50 is 149 into 99 upon 100 raised to 1. So that is your answer. Clear? Next question, 106. Homework mai bodo. Question number 10. Acha, actually number ma printing mistake chhe. Again 104 thi start kyu chhe. But 104 de, ke bijo je 104 chhe ne, ki binomial distribution no question nahi. actually Bayes' theorem no question che, so that we will solve afterwards. First we will solve the question which are of the binomial theorem. So next is question number 105. Question number 105. 105 A number. So last 105 hatho ne. 105, 105, 104, 105, 106, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, 104, 105, one trial, and Q is probability of failure in one trial. Okay, so for this, we have two formulas, that is mean and variance. Mean and variance. So for that, formula for mean is n into t. Formula for mean is n into t. And formula for variance is n into p into q. अबे formula जे for binomial distribution. Mean is n into t and variance is n into p into q. Okay, now in question 105, binomial distribution is given as 4, 1 by 3. binomial distribution is given as 4, 1 by 3. Last lecture में मैं कहता हूँ, द्वारा type का binomial distribution है कोई, then it is of the form like this, n, p. binomial distribution n, p means first value is at first value indicates the value of n, and second value indicates the value of t. So here n is 4 and p is 1 by 3. So now formula for mean is n into p. So that is 4 into 1 by 3. So that is 4 by 3. Okay, variance कोई चुना नहीं, but we will find variance is n into p into q. So that is 4 into 1 by 3. P is 1 by 3. So value of q is 2 by 3. Value of q is 2 by 3. So that is 8 by 9. So mean is 4 by 3 and variance is 8 by 9. Clear? Next question, question number 106. The probability that a shooter hits the target is 3 by 4. Find the minimum number of times he must fire so that the probability of hitting the target at least one is more than 0.99. Question 106. Here success is let we try let total number of trials are okay. Success is hitting the target. Success is hitting a target. Now, what is the probability in one shot the hit the target is 3 by 4. So, P is equals to 3 by 4. So, you can find from that Q is 1 by 4. Now, what is the question? Find the minimum number of times. It means we have to find the minimum value of N for which he must fire so that probability of hitting the target at least one means first we will make our formula for probability distribution. P of x is equals to x is n c x p raised to x q raised to n minus x. We don't know the value of n, so n c x p is 3 by 4 raised to x into 1 by 4 raised to n minus x. Okay. Now your question is the probability of hitting a target at least once means x is greater than or equal to 1. Any probability is more than 0.99. Probability is more than 0.99. From that, we have to find the value of n. Okay. So, p of x greater than or equal to 1. So, we can write 1 minus p of x is equal to 0 is greater than 0.99. 1 minus p of x is equal to 0. At least 1 is greater than or equal to 1. In our diary, we can say 1 minus p of x is equal to 0 is greater than 0.99. So, 1 minus. When you substitute x equals to 0, it will be nc 0. 3 by 4 raised to 0, 1 by 4 raised to n is greater than 0.99. Okay. So 1 minus nc 0 is 1, anything raised to 0 is 1, and here it is 1 upon 4 raised to n is greater than 0.99. So I can write 1 minus 0.99 is greater than 1 upon 4 raised to n. And what's it like? 0.99 is like. So that is 0.01 is greater than 1 upon 4 raised to n. So I can write 1 upon 4 raised to n is less than 0.01 means 1 by 100. 0.01 is 1 upon 100. Now, when you take reciprocal of this, inequality will be changed. When you take reciprocal of this, inequality will be changed. So 1 upon 4 raised to n is less than 1 by 100, then 4 raised to n is greater than 100. So possible values of n. N is number of trial, whatever, so it is a whole number. So if you take n equal to 1, 4 greater than 100, it is not true. N equal to 2, 16 greater than 100, not true. 3, 64 greater than 100, not true. 4, yes, 4 raised to 4, 64 into 4 is 256, it is greater than 4. So possible values of n is 4, 5, 6, this. So minimum value of n is 4. Minimum value of n is equal to 4 means abadi value possible. You can take n is equal to 4 or 5 or 6, 7, 8, anything. But question ma pane sothi dojan hitting a target at least find the number of time he must fire, so that find the minimum number of times he must fire, so that the probability of hitting a target at least one is more than 0.99. Minimum n no number find karvano chhe. So minimum number is 4. Okay. Next question. હવે બાયનોમિયલ ડિસ્ટ્રિબ્યુશન ટાઈપના જેટલા પ્રોબ્લેમ્સ હતા ને એ આપણે કમ્પ્લીટ કરી લીધા. હવે બધા ક્વેશ્ચન મિસેલેનિયસ ટાઈપના છે, મિક્સ હશે. આઈધર ઇટ ઇઝ ફ્રોમ બેઝ થિયરમ ઓર ઇટ ઇઝ ફ્રોમ બાયનોમિયલ ડિસ્ટ્રિબ્યુશન ઓર કન્ડિશનલ પ્રોબેબિલિટી એને. સો વી સ્ટાર્ટ વિથ ધ અગેન ક્વેશ્ચન નંબર 104. ઇફ 104 પોઈન્ટ તો આપણે આગળ કરી લીધો છે. 104 એ કલર્ડ બોલ્સ આર ડિસ્ટ્રિબ્યુટેડ ઇન ફોર બોક્સ એઝ શોન ઇન ધ ફોલોઇંગ ટેબલ્સ. Four boxes are given, 1, 2, 3, and different colors of ball are black, white, red, and blue. Okay. In first box, there are 3 black balls, 4 white balls, 5 red balls, and 5 blue balls. 2, 2, 2, 2. 1, 2, 3, 1. 4, 3, 1, 5. Now, a box is selected at random. A ball is drawn from the selected box at random. If the color of selected ball is black, find the probability that the ball drawn is from the box 2. Okay, so here. First, we have to assume 4 events, that is E1, E2, E3 and E4. E1 is box 1 is selected. E2 is box 2 is selected. E3 is box 3 is selected. And E4 is box 4 is selected. Okay. So, P of E1, when the box select how probability equals. So P of E1 is 1 by 4. P of E2 is also 1 by 4. P of E3 is also 1 by 4. P of E4 is also 1 by 4. Event A, Q pole select thai chai, selected pole is black. Let event A, selected pole is a black. Selected pole is a black. Okay. So now here, what is the probability of A less even? Let me show you base theorem. A less even means even event has already occurred. Means we know that first box is selected. Then what is the probability? The color of color of ball is black. So in box 1, there are 5 plus 5, 10, 14, 17 ball are there. Ema thi black ball kitla? So the black balls are 3. So A less even is 3 by 7. A less E2. Total number of balls are 8. Out of that, black balls are 2. So 2 by 8. A less E3. Total number of balls are 2 plus 3, 5. Sorry, 3, 6, 7. And out of that, black balls are A less E4 means fourth box is selected. And total number of balls are 7, 8, 13. And black balls are 4. So that is 4 by 13. Now, question is, if black ball is selected, the ball, it is drawn from the box 2. You have to find A ball is selected, that we know. This A event has already occurred. Then what is the probability it is come from the box 2? This E2 slash A. So formula for E2 slash A is A slash E2 up to E2 on P of A. So first, we need to find is P of A. P of A is even into A less even. Formula one is the now they just have E2 into A less E2. 2 by 8 means 1 by 4. 1 by 4 into 1 by 7 plus 1 by 4 into 1 by 13. 1 by 4 is 4. If you take it 3 by 17, 1 by 4, 1 by 7, 4 by 1 by 4 into LCM is 17 into 4 into 7 into 13. Okay, so calculation is a little bit lengthy. 13 into 9 is 7 is 91. 91 into 4 is 364. 364 into 3. So it is 1092 plus 17 into 13, that is 170 plus 51, 221, 221 into 7. So, 1547, 221 into 4, it is 884, and last 17 into 7, that is 119 into 4. 76. So that is your P of A. So now put the value of P of A from here. And S less E2 is 1 by 4 into 1 by 4. So you can simplify by your way. Clear? So that is the question number 104. Next question 105 and 106 has already done. Now question number 107. Question number 107. If a machine is correctly set up, it produces 90% acceptable item. If it is incorrectly set, it produces only 40% acceptable items. It is observed that 80% of the time the machine is set up correctly. So here mainly two parts. E1 and E2 is it is observed that 81 machine is set up correctly. E2 is machine is set up incorrectly. So here P of E1 is given. In the 80% of time, it is correctly set up. So 80/100. So that is 0, 0 cancel. 4/5. And P of E2, it is 20/100. So that is 1/5. Okay. Now, if after a certain setup, the machine produces two acceptable items, right? U and A. Machine produces two acceptable items. Okay. Here, Sudhina question ma mostly ek aj vastu aapta ahi puche two acceptable items. So P of A slash E1. Mainly student I am mistake karel. P of A slash E1 means we know that E1 event has already occurred, means machine is set up correctly, that we know. तो तुमने प्रोबेबिलिटी शो आपी है कि इट प्रोड्यूसेस 90% एक्सेप्टेबल आइटम 90% एक्सेप्टेबल आइटम तो एक आइटम माटे सक्सेस की प्रोबेबिलिटी मींस एक्सेप्टेबल आइटम प्रोड्यूस થઈ એની પ્રોબેબિલિટી 90% છે બટ અહીં આપણે કેટલી મળે છે ટુ એક્સેપ્ટેબલ આઇટમ્સ મીન્સ પહેલી આઇટમ જે છે એ એક્સેપ્ટેબલ છે સેકન્ડ આઇટમ છે એ પણ એક્સેપ્ટેબલ છે તો ફર્સ્ટ આઇટમ એક્સેપ્ટેબલ થઈ એની પર્સન્ટેજ 90% सेकंड आइटम एक्सेप्टेबल थे इना परसेंटेज 90% 90 जाएगा 90% सो एस लेस ई1 इज 90/100 इनटू 90/100 सो इट इज 81/100 सो इट इज 81/100 ओके एंड पी ऑफ एस लेस ई2 इफ वी नो दैट द मशीन इज सेट अप इनकरेक्टली देन एक्सेप्टेबल आइटम्स केस आर 40% तो B आइटम एक्सेप्टेबल हुई, फर्स्ट आइटम एक्सेप्टेबल हुई, इना परसेंटेज 40%, सेकंड आइटम इज आल्सो करेक्टेबल, इना परसेंटेज है 40%, सो दैट इज 40/100, अप टू 40/100, सो दैट इज 16/100, दैट इज 16/100, फाइंड द प्रोबेबिलिटी दैट मशीन इज करेक्टली सेट अप मींस हियर वी हैव टू फाइंड इफ वी नो दैट बोथ द आइटम्स आर करेक्टली बोथ द आइटम्स आर एक्सेप्टेबल And it produce a machine is set up correctly. We have to find E1/A. We have to find E1/A. So formula for E1/A is A/E1 into E1 upon P of A. So first we need to find is P of A. So P of A is P of E1 into A/E1 plus P of E2 into A/E2. P of E1 is 4/5, S less E1 is 81/100, plus E2 is 1/5, S less E2 is 60/100. The LCM is 100 into 5, that is 500, 81 into 4 is 324 plus 16. So that is 324 plus 16 is 340 upon 500. Okay, now here S less E1 is 4/5. Sorry, S less E1 is 81/100 into P of E1 is 4/5 whole divided by P of A is 340 upon 500. 500 cancel. 40 cancel karo. So that is 48 are 32. 0. That is 81 upon 85. 81 upon 85. डेसिमल में कन्वर्ट कर लेजो योर आंसर इज गिवन 0.95 ओके नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन क्वेश्चन 108 और क्वेश्चन 108 करता पेला छे ने एक थ्योरी छे थ्योरी कराई दो ये मायनो यूज થશે It is odds in favor and odds in odds against. odds in favor for event A and odds against the event E. Okay. Let it is given that odds in favor for event E is n by n. Odds in favor for event is m by n. Ano meaning so dio? M is favorable outcomes. And n is unfavorable outcomes. Probability nahi hai. Odds in favor for event is m equal to n, but m chahiye tamara favorable outcomes diya. અને અનફેવરેબલ આઉટકમ્સ કેટલા થયા n. તો હવે આપણે પ્રોબેબિલિટી ઓફ ઈ ફાઇન્ડ કરવી હોય તો ફોર ધીસ પ્રોબેબિલિટી ઓફ ઈ ઇઝ ફેવરેબલ આઉટકમ્સ અપોન ટોટલ આઉટકમ્સ. તો હિયર ફેવરેબલ આઉટકમ ઇઝ m ઇન ટોટલ આઉટકમ્સ ફેવરેબલ પ્લસ અનફેવરેબલ ધેટ ઇઝ m પ્લસ ધેટ ઇઝ m plus n. So, if you have said that odds in favor for event is m by n, then probability of E is m upon m plus n. Suppose you have said that odds in favor for event E is equals to 2:1, then P of E is 2 upon 3. Total outcomes is 2 plus 1. Ratio. So P of E is 2 by K. I am going to odds against event E is M by M. Odds against event E is M by M. Anu matlab so thai, numerator is unfavorable outcome. And denominator is favorable outcome. અગેન સાઇક હોય તો ન્યુમરેટરમાં અનફેવરેબલ આઉટકમ હોય અને ડિનોમિનેટરમાં ફેવરેબલ આઉટકમ ધેન પ્રોબેબિલિટી ઓફ ઈ વિલ બી તો કે પ્રોબેબિલિટી ઓફ ઈ ની ડેફિનેશન તો એ જ રહે કે ફેવરેબલ આઉટકમ ડિવાઇડેડ બાય ટોટલ આઉટકમ્સ તો હિયર ફેવરેબલ આઉટકમ્સ આર એન તો ફોર ધીસ કેસ પ્રોબેબિલિટી ઓફ ઈ ઇઝ એન અપોન એન પ્લસ એન પ્રોબેબિલિટી ઓફ ઈ ઇઝ એન અપોન એમ પ્લસ એન ઓકે વી ટેક એક્ઝામ્પલ ફોર ધીસ Let odds against event E is 4:7. Then P of E. So odds against I point there Q level as a second weight that is your favorable outcomes because it is unfavorable outcome, then it is favorable outcomes. So probability is favorable outcome that is 7 and total outcomes are 7 plus 4, 11. So for this case, odds against event A is 4:7, then probability of E is 7/11. Now, question number 108, the odds in favor of Sanya over Martina in a match is 2:3. Find whether the best 2 out of 3 or the best 3 out of 5 give more edge for Sanya win the series. Kon win a series win kare ni probability find karvani chhe, toke Sanya. To sauthi pehla Sanya win thai ni probability ketli thase, toke Sanya na odds in favor to 2:3 છે સાનિયા odds in favor is 2:3 તો chances of Sanya will win that is 2/5 Sanya જીતે એની probability કેટલી થાય 2/5 તો હવે જો best 2 out of 3 match હશે તો Sanya જીતશે એની probability વધારે થશે કે 3 આઉટ ઓફ 5 મેચ હશે તો સાનિયાની વિન થવાની પ્રોબેબિલિટી વધારે હશે એ તમારે ફાઇન્ડ કરવાનું છે ટ્રાય કરજો નો થાય નેક્સ્ટ લેક્ચરમાં હું કરાવીશ મે બી થઈ જશે બેમાંથી સેમ પ્રોબેબિલિટી વધારે છે તમારે ફાઇન્ડ કરવાનું છે આઈધર ઇન બેસ્ટ ઓફ 3 ઓર ઇન ધ બેસ્ટ ઓફ 5 ઓકે ટ્રાય ઇટ થેન્ક યુ